Well, hello there, everyone. You show right here is the Gold Monument 24 right here. And you see right here, this painting, Photoshop painting right here, actually talks about the disability. And if we're talking about like the disability rights, or if it's any source of other source of disability. But you see right here is that this right here will be a painting right here of me right here. And let's just say that, if I was about maybe 8 years old, a couple of pictures that I had with my natural hair that look like I was at least maybe, 3, 4, something like that. But based on, some of the other pictures that we've seen, talk about for the Gold Monument, North Tarikia, and as well as for what's paid for, and, after graduation. The main reason why I wanted to do these activities, sequels, is talking about for whenever graduation and birthday come at the same time. But of course, if we're like warrant toward, if we're going to have, especially if it's related to our taxes, if you're going to have any loan repayments that you got to make, and then nowadays that they got these services to where that if you are claimed to be 100% disability, of claim to have a disability. Or any source of anything about that, for what you qualify, because I know nowadays that they have it, especially on our tax return, that if you're claiming to be 100% disabled, or I don't know, like if anybody warns us that if you recently, maybe if you recently gotten married and knowing about the what could be qualified for any source of state credits from there, especially on your taxes, but. This painting right here actually shows me right here with my natural hair, and if anybody will warrant to wear that, how does it go from like blonde to a dark brown, type color? Yeah, but still, that you say that look at your own, baby photos and just thinking about it, as to where it looked pretty cute in some of those photos. And whenever I was looking, I'll tell you, like, especially on my art store, that you can buy prints on curls.com, so that if anybody warns us, if you want to go in and buy any t-shirts or, anything you relate to your carbis, it's like your glass prints on there that, will be working on, getting this painting up, posted up if we've seen one about the eclipse, and then as well as that you'll feel their paintings as well. But you see right here is that I educational you type of paintings also, but this right here talks about my disability. So I know the last video I posted was talking about paid for business trips. So if anybody will warrant toward it, that whenever they graduate, or like anybody say that if you're going to be out looking for work, and maybe not everything is going to go by the original plan, because I know with me, though, that after I graduated, that I was trying to work on, paying back the loans, working out the taxes. And whenever things get delayed or postponed or canceled, that's pretty aggravating, too. And if anybody were warned to her, that what has been gotten delayed and what has been postponed. But, a few things I can think about. One of them is jobs. It's like if you're going to be working on a resume, and a few things that you get delayed based on your resume, if it's maybe not enough experience, or the Gold Monument year. But the cover letter that I included with my resume talks about whenever birthday and graduation come at the same time. So the date that I wrote on there would have been 7/18 of 2000. I'm going to just put the full year, so that way we can see that, but for 2018 right there. So whenever we think about this, is that for next year, that keep thinking that it seems like nothing's going to happen, because because summer's almost over with, and then just thinking that for how much progress that I was able to have so far as with looking for work. But if anybody were saying that, there was one time not too long ago to where that you were having fun playing with the Legos, or maybe with the Lincoln Logs and stuff, playing with your toys that you would usually get on your birthday, whenever you're going to have a birthday, like your 10th birthday or maybe your 12th birthday, that maybe any coloring books or anything like that, just thinking that, you really, during that time that you did not even know what a W-2 form or, any other source of tax document was. So, really, that whenever you're at a young age, that a lot of that stuff that that may not apply to you just because that maybe that if you're working or not, or that anything that you qualify for. And we weren't to where that maybe if it's every year, or maybe every 2 years or every 3 years, that they're going to be doing something on our tax return. One of those would be is to where that if you're claiming to be at maybe an independent or something, or if you are a part-time or a full-time student. So let's just say that within 2 years from now, that you are going to be claimed to be a full-time student, and then they might even say that we'll be willing to reimburse you on the cost of the books, and as well as anything about you for what your financial aid and your bail range also. So whenever we file our taxes, that whenever we first were introduced to it, especially if anybody say that, especially on my birthday. On my birthday comes in July. That's usually around the time the tax time is over with. So you're like thinking about what's so gold monument about that. But the idea I came up with mainly was talking about whenever graduation and birthday come at the same time. But let's just say that if it's also maybe marriage also. But really, that I also want to talk about right here is talk about with signatures, because if anybody were to say that, whenever you have something delivered, let's just say if you ordered it after you graduate, then let's just say that the purpose could be is to where that you want to go ahead and gain some experience of ordering something online. In order to be able to do that you go to the website and yeah, that your first time ordering something online and just thinking that okay, well, let's just say that if you gotten a gift card, you received a gift card, maybe not a credit card, but a gift card. If you got a gift card for your birthday present, and let's just say that maybe the original plan is like to word it, yeah, that on your birthday, that your graduation, after you graduated, then you were applying somewhere, but then they say that you got a gift card, to go, shopping somewhere or something, and like anybody say that, nowadays they would maybe recommend a gift card other than putting, cash in a card, in a greeting card. But let's just say that if it is a gift card, and then just thinking as to where you go shop online, and thinking that the things that you can get on there, and then have them delivered, or pick them up at the local store. But the main purpose, of course, is talking about jobs. So that with my disability, that you with anybody, if you're going to be claimed to have a disability, that it seems like that to where it puts you on a number of restrictions to the point where if you can't find a job, and you get all frustrated about it, and just think about as to where the whole purpose about the gold monument, and if anybody warrants is that the cover letter, that you were not able to read very many details about the cover letter, and the cover letter, whenever I went to my first job interview, that I gave them a cover letter, and it basically worded it to where that it did not say anything such as, please hire me, I am a good worker, here are my goals, for this so far as this next few weeks or anything like that. What the cover letter basically mentioned is to where whenever graduation and birthday come at the same time, and then the number of goals and progresses that you want to have achieved, and let's just say if it's 7 months from now, that's basically what it says. And I don't know if anybody will warrant to where that they would want to put that even on a disability card, to where please accept me as being a professional, or please hire me, I am willing to do the job correctly, or anything like that. So whenever I first posted up about the gold monument, that I was talking about our taxes, but let's just say that this right here will be example right here of papers, or maybe a notepad right here, but to talk about the source of income. And really, that gold monument could also be related to the source of income. But still, that if you're going to be claimed to have a disability, though, that like with me, though, that it seems like to where that with disability benefits, or if you're going to have any source of a disability that at the time, that some that may say if you're going to have a disability, that it seems like that don't expect people to feel sorry for you. Well, that's your own problem. You deal with it, but still, that how many of us going to maybe think as to where that really, are you too afraid to say that you got disability other than the fact about that you got student loan repayments that you got to make. How many of us are going to maybe vote 50-50 or something like that? Which one would you rather deal with? Student loan repayments, or to say that, you got a disability, so, you worked it out through financial aid on your taxes forms about, how to take care of that. But really, that for what is confidential, or what is what you call is like, okay, the real gold monument. What is this gold monument? And people may think that I just made this up, but still, between talking about graduation and between talking about job offer or talk about paid vacation or paid business trip, that I want to do this activity right here of talking about the gold monument, as if this was right here was supposed to be one of my paintings. But let's just say that you got disability, and then when did the doctors diagnose you with this disability? It was probably around at birth, and then whenever you were about maybe 8 or maybe 10 years old, that you went through some test, and then that's what they said that you diagnosed with. So, and sometimes, whenever I was in school, though, that a lot of times, it seems like that compared me to a few of the other school kids also, because it seems like whenever you're going to have problems, it seems like not everybody's going to be born to be perfect. Not everybody's born to be perfect, but on the other hand, it really is something to be thankful for and something to be proud of. And one of those I would always say is to where, your artistic talent is one of them. But so far as the speech and grammar, and as far as anything about academic achievements, or if it's anything about for what it is paid for. But really, that whenever I think about this right here, that it's like anybody say that so far as how's the job research going, and I just feel like saying this to her that if I really even want to talk about it, because it seems like you think that you have something already arranged or in mind, but then after a few weeks later and then something else comes up to where since you're claiming to have a disability that you're not even making student loan repayments right now, or something else came up on your financial aid, or if it's anything about on your tax papers. So if anybody were the one to where that after you graduate, that there may be a number of things that you don't want to do, and just thinking about is to where that that there may be a lot of school kids that may think is to where anybody that if you're trying to get something done, that a number of things that for how we want to say that this sucks, or something, this sucks, or this is not fair that I got to deal with this or that. But talk about for the Gold Monument 24 that I mainly want to talk about right here is talking about with my disability, because tell anybody that people that use that word or phrase is to where kind of like other names of what we want to call it, but still that for like the respectful manners to where issues. And the type of other source of disability diagnosis that they diagnose people with, but still, that if it's another source of way of how to get attention from the state or from the government, or if anybody see from Department of Education, that whenever they talking, whenever you were in school before that you even knew about how to work the mobile app, that this is what you were doing. And then now it's like since you have problems with your spelling and grammar, and then it took you a couple times even from the first grade to learn how to spell your last name. And I can tell anybody here that, I think in the first grade, if I can remember right, in the first grade, I can remember that. In the first grade that I had problems trying to spell my last name correctly. I had to look on my desk, I don't know if I told anybody, here yet about that story, but I think it was take a math test or some sort of test. They said that write your last name on the paper, and I had to look on the desk a couple times because I'm like, you knew how to spell your first name, but you just didn't know how to spell your last name. And whenever you're first grade, whenever you're about 8 years old, that you may not know how to spell certain things, or that write down that nowadays whenever they grade papers nowadays, knowing about what they want you to do so far as grading the paperwork, grading the test, but still whenever I was in school, of course, if anybody were to say where's this gold monument stuff, it's a name that I gave it because a lot of times if anybody say how many of us are going to have a birthday right around the time whenever school's over with, or if anything, that whenever summer school's coming around or whenever summer school's going on, that whenever you graduate, for how many of us are going to say that if you're going to be claim to have a disability and knowing the things that they'll give you. And tell anybody that really, whenever you file your taxes, if a disability is going to allow it to where you don't have to make any student loan repayments or anything, it's going to be up to 3 years from then, it's finally decided about, and if you decide to go back to school or anything like that, and then they'll tell you a little bit something else. But really, about the whole purpose about the gold monument, that's just something too easily to remember to about exactly what's going on so far as the job research goes, and as well as whenever my birthday comes around, and I know since last year that whenever I got my certificate from last year, it was like just thinking as to where I didn't know how long it was going to take until I actually got something. So if anybody were to say that from back in back in August that you said that you, but then and then they were telling you something different, that you gotta get enough income together just to be able to get it, or something else came up, things were postponed or delayed. So that's just another thing too about is toward it, number of things that come up, and then that you can't get something done right away, and then they tell you something else to where that either that it's too expensive, or that you're trying to get to something worked in the process. But talk about for the gold monument though, that's of course for next year. And if anybody were warned toward it, if it's not gonna be paid vacation or paid a business trip or paid honeymoon or anything like that, and knowing about the purpose about the gold monument is to where that being claimed to be a U.S. citizen. And if anybody were warned to where that those are like a two questions that they ask me whenever I file my taxes or whenever I'm filling out a job application. They don't really ask me about, any information about your blood type. And if anybody were warned to where maybe the Department of Education, the Disability Department, they would maybe ask you about what your blood type is and what your diagnosis, what your disorder is. But they would ask you if you're a U.S. citizen. And as also is that they would also ask you other source of information about you, if you're local resident or anything like that. But really, that the questions that they ask you, that I just really think too is toward it. If anybody warned toward it, that so far as the gold monument goes, is that they ask you about your date of birth and other source of general questions like that. But still, that at the time you weren't to where, what does that have to do with what we're applying for? If you're applying for a job, and then they tell you some specific things also. But talk about for the gold monument right here, talk about for disability. And knowing about if anybody say that, I say you claim to have disability, but other than that, then I know nobody. It's like that special gift and I like to keep in mind. But anyway, thanks for watching, everyone, and talk about the gold monument 24 color activity.